Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. It's Friday after work and we have a couple things going on tonight. Bailey got him some new wheels. Those are not them, they're back here. I forgot, I picked them up. Got him some fortune wheels for his second gen. So we gotta get these unloaded, get these put on the truck, and he also has a piece of exhaust pipe. He's gonna cut out his stock exhaust and straight pipe this thing. We also got a tail light we're gonna put in it. Just had one laying around there. Finish that one off here. We'll stick a tail light in this thing. Mason's watching YouTube videos. And, he's bored. And then, yeah, we're gonna get this thing jacked up and get these tires put on it, straight pipe it. So, this truck is officially getting ruined. It was a good truck until now. So. Yeah, that's a real nice straight pipe you got. I think, what is that off of, a Duramax? Got the new meats. Pretty good shape too. Get those put on there. So yeah, kind of see what this weekend brings. I'm gonna try to tie all this together in one video. Bailey got her all straight piped up. It's like a tractor, man. Just like a tractor. Got the fortunes on there. Oh, they rub. You guys see, I got my light on so I can see. Got some stakes going on the Pit Boss smoker over here. Got some prime rib over here. Or no, filet mignon, I'm sorry. There's mine, I like mine rare. That's why mine's off the heat. Cooking some steaks, man. All right, guys, in Muncie right now, shopping. Buying clothes. Caitlin tells me I have to buy clothes because apparently I don't have enough clothes, or they're all greasy and destroyed. So she made me go buy some clothes, and we're gonna run to Derek's after this and check out his truck a little bit. It's been a while since we've seen his truck on the channel, and he has it all finished and smetting. Got us hooked up with a pretty new turbo setup with it, so we just got that put on. So we're gonna go over to his house, check it out, look at the truck since it's been painted, and check out that new smetting turbo he's got on there as well. So yeah, we're gonna run into another store real quick and then we'll catch up with you guys over at Derek's. I also was looking at trying to get a new camera, but Best Buy does not have one. I wanted to get the I want to get a new camera for the channel. I was looking at either the Canon G7X Mark II. But they only have Mark IIIs here, and I'm not gonna buy the Mark III. It's basically the same thing as the Mark II, just like $300 more. And I was also looking at the Sony, the VZ1. It's like basically the ultimate vlogging camera. But they just came out, and the Mark VII, or yeah, G7, whatever, Mark II Canon has been out for a while. So I don't know, we're gonna go back here and look around a little bit more. Hey guys, we're over here at Derek's. And he's gonna show us his truck. This is gonna be the first time it's on the channel since last time we came out here and did that video.
A long way since then.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to look and see what video it was whenever. I don't even know. I'm gonna have to dig through them and look. But we pulled it out of the garage up there, if you remember right. Right when you got it running.
Yeah,
and
I got the motor done.
Yeah, I think you barely had the bed on there, like the cab bolts were loose. I remember that.
Yeah,
so
it might have been loose.
But he got it all painted up, painted it himself. It looks really good. He hasn't collar sanded it yet, and it's a little dirty just from
the dog jumping on it.
Dog jumping on it, I guess. He's got a big old 140-pound tank. But I think once he gets some wet sanding and some buffing done, this paint's gonna look pretty much perfect. It does look really, really good. It's just got a little orange peel, but I mean, for painting it yourself, man, I'll be honest with you, I'm impressed. It looks really good. So he also, just wanted to show you guys, he had the Aurora 5000 on there, but
it was just choking it up, man.
It was fine at first, but then once you know,
put delivery valves in it, and it just had too much fuel.
It was too much fuel for it, so we got hooked up with the Smedding 369. I don't know what's
SXE. That? It's got a T4. It's got 90 on exhaust housing.
And got the manifold from them. They were able to machine the elbow there, where I literally, just use all the factory stuff. And luckily, he already had an HX40 style downpipe, so he's able to put that right on. And it looks like it fits pretty well. You already know he's not running an air filter on it because he just doesn't do that.
No, I need to get it.
He needs to get an air filter.
It did go on there really smoothly, though, yeah. I will say.
I mean, aside from changing the manifold, I mean, you'd say it's, you know, pretty much a bolt-on, really.
Yeah.
I mean, like all your intercooler piping and stuff was still able to work. So.
Oh, yeah.
Huge shout out to the guys over at Smedding, and there's always a discount code in the link in the description. You can get 5% off. It's Dirty Dummy Diesel 5, I think. You just have to look. So you guys can go and check out all the Smedding products. But yeah, he's got her all done.
Probably take her for a little drive.
Probably take her for a little drive here in a second.
Yeah.
That's an auto truck. Has all of the P pump stuff off of the Thummins. So just a stock. I don't know if it's a 160 or 180 pump. I can't remember.
180.
Stock 180 pump with 4Ks. Timing is advanced.
Rack plug and delivery
valves. Rack plugs, full cut delivery valves, and 7x12s.
Yes.
7x12 injectors. So it runs fairly well, but still trying to get it tuned out a little bit. It really still wants to kind of choke that turbo out, you think, a little bit?
Yeah, I need a bigger lift pump.
Yeah? You think it's a lift pump, maybe?
Yeah, it's running out of fuel.
And there's also no fuel plate at all. This has like the little, I had that on the Thummins, but I had stock injectors, so it ran all right. But you got all this fuel, you really might need to maybe get a way to control it a little bit.
Yeah.
But either way, she's running good. He's got a good turbo on there now that he can make some power with. So we'll fire this thing up and we'll go for a spin. What's that here? Is that converter lock?
Yeah. I didn't want to put a switch in right here.
Yeah. Just temporary.
No, it's permanent.
That's permanent.
Yeah.
What?
Not that time.
Not that time?
No, I wasn't.
You lock it too early? Still trying to figure this thing out, but it runs pretty good. It's running pretty good. Just need to dial that fuel in a little more. Right. It's just a lot of fuel. It's not too much fuel can be a problem. I mean, you can lose power that way.
Might need to put a fuel plate in.
Fuel plate maybe, and then maybe set up some boost reference.
Yeah, it's not.
Yeah.
I hope it doesn't throw a drive shaft or something. Yeah, it's gonna have a Martin sticker on it. Yeah, there we go. And the police just keep running us off. So now we're at our homeland. They ain't gonna mess with us here, man. We tied in tight.
We keep lights on at this place.
Yeah. So this is Eli's new truck. You guys remember he had the 12 valve and got rid of it because he can't keep anything.
I had to get a dad truck.
He had to get a dad truck. So we understand. So go ahead and show us what you've done to it so far.
It's got some new tires on it.
You got some new meats.
eBay 35s, ride good, balance good.
You're good for fields. Yeah.
Oh yeah, dude. Just doing country shit in the dirt. Never been stuck. At the $56 eBay intake horn. Mostly mile per gallon increase, you know, 20 on the interstate. Custom made dipstick holder with all thread, double nutted so you know it's not coming off. Went ahead and went with the AFE torque tube here instead of an open element filter because we do country shit and it'll clog the filter.
So exactly.
We gotta have the air box on there with the cane and drop in. Oiled up, just catching everything. It's got a used Smarty on it. She barks, straight pipe.
It looks good though, it really does look really good. Got the toolbox in there.
We fix stuff.
Just rolling up now. What do you think of them wheels though, son? What do you think of those tires on the shorty?
I mean, can't beat a destination AT from Firestone, especially when you get the tire wet on it. There's no other tire like it.
You know, the white walls are out for a reason.
Yeah, top of the line, matches the paint. Show winner quality, for sure.
All right, guys, that is pretty much going to wrap it up for this video. Kind of just random, just running around is what we did this weekend. Didn't really do much working on anything, but you guys got to see Derek's truck. We did the straight pipe Bailey's truck, did a couple other things to it, got some wheels on it, and got the shorty put on. Well, you guys have already seen, I guess, on the stock wheels, but just cruising around on there. The meet was a pretty good time, although the cops came and shut it down pretty early. I don't know, kind of ridiculous, honestly. It was just a bunch of people hanging out and having a good time. And yeah, the cops are just kind of watching us the whole night, pulling people over for stupid stuff. So I don't know. I mean, it's kind of just pathetic more than anything, you know. Just really wanting to harass us all. You know, a couple people were being a little obnoxious with their trucks, but at the end of the day, just people having fun. You know, no one got hurt or anything like that, so I don't really see what the big deal is. But anyways, that is gonna wrap it up. Be sure to like and subscribe to the channel and check out Dirty Diamond merchandise in the link of this description below. And follow me on Instagram, DylanLee73. See you guys on the next one.